Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. All you lovers of literature, it's a great pleasure for me, on behalf of Taj Bengal, to welcome you at our hotel. So as you're aware that the author's afternoon is an initiative of the Prabhaketan Foundation, thanks to Sandeep Pretoria and our association, that we put this together quite often. And this is an opportunity to meet some great authors and to be in conversation with them, hear them, talk to them. And so today is another day. This is also to let you know that this is in collaboration with D2 of Telegraph, Taj Bengal, and hosted by Sri Cements Limited. It's an honor to present and welcome Savi Sharma, co-founder of the motivational media blog Life and People, where she writes about the law of attraction, positivity, spirituality, traveling, and storytelling. She left her CA studies to become a storyteller. And in conversation with her is Ms. Nilisha Agarwal, who also happens to be a CA, marketing and brand strategist. And to add my two bits here is, I think they are the youngest that we have ever had in an author's afternoon. So I'm sure we are looking out for really an exciting conversation. Welcome both of you.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Yes, Savi. So I'll start with a very meaningful question. Mm-hmm. What is your story?
Well, Sarath has already given you an introduction. So I was doing CA and I left my CA studies to be a storyteller. I was always intrigued by stories. I always felt that, you know, whatever I have experienced in my life, I should share with other people. It may happen that someone else is also going through certain situations which I have faced. And maybe my experience can help them to ignore those mistakes which I made or to give them a solution for their problems. And my mission in life is to inspire millions of souls. And I feel that through storytelling, I'm able to do this. And I can really inspire people where I was. And that's what I'm trying to do.
Wow, that's great. You know, to inspire everyone around. And what inspired you to start writing?
As I said, that I always felt that I need to share my experiences. So since my school days, I used to write. I gave my first presentation when I was in second or first year. I wrote my first poetry. It was something about life. I don't remember what it was. But since then, I used to take part in every competitions related to writing or speeches in school competition, in the school and everything. And I decided that I want to do something in the field of writing. Maybe I'll write articles in columns for newspaper or magazine. Or maybe job of RJ, because there also you form some content from stories. But during the first year of my college, I started reading books. And that was the time I started reading novels. There were 10 days for my CA result, CA IPCC. And I read around 12 novels in those 10 days. And after reading those 12 novels, I was like, I don't want to write articles, I want to write stories. Like, I'm made to tell stories and not numbers. And then I decided I want to leave CA and I want to write. So that was my inspiration, that was a turning point of my life when I started writing my first book.
So it must have taken a lot of courage to leave CA, you know, after almost clearing IPCC and, you know, just the finals left.
Yes.
Why did you not think of completing CA and then writing? Or, you know, what really made you, what was the tipping point?
Yes, it was very tough, and the toughest part was to convince my parents that I want to leave CA. Why I didn't continue CA, it was like, you know, I'm in Surat and I want to go to Delhi, but I know that I'm going to Mumbai. So both are in opposite directions. But while reaching Vapi, I realized that I'm the train to Mumbai, I'm not in the train to Delhi. So I felt that it's of no use that I go to Mumbai and then I come back, because it will take 2 more hours to go to Mumbai. So I decided that I want to stop at the station itself and I want to take the correct train. And so I decided that, no, I want to live right here. I didn't want to waste more time in CA, because CA was not something that was making me happy and it was not something I wanted to do in life. And it was useless to do CA just because people can say that I have a good degree and my parents can say that my daughter or daughter is chartered accountant and they can say that they will search a proper groom according to my degree. So I didn't want to do that, and that's why I decided that I wanted to leave. My parents were unhappy initially. They said that at least complete your CA, because most of the Lebanese parents are like, a degree is the securest thing. And art is something you can just make passion. It can be a passion. It can't be made into a profession. But I do know that I can do it. I'll make them proud of you. So it was tough to see them unhappy every day. But I knew that it's for a small time. And today they are very proud and they tell me that we were wrong, that we were trying to stop you. And we are glad that you didn't stop there. Otherwise, we would not be able to forgive ourselves for life.
Indeed, they must be very proud.
Yes. You know,
best-selling author.
Yeah, they are really.
So, how do you start writing a book? What are, like, do you have a story in mind before, or you know, do you build up the story once you start writing? Okay. What is the inspiration before you write it?
My writing process is, first and foremost, I decide the soul of the story. This is the message I want to give through this book.
Right.
And once the soul is written, the message is written, I decide the characters, that which characters will be apt to form that story, to complete that story, because it's your characters who complete your story, who are narrating your story to your readers. You don't narrate, your characters do that. So I decide a character, I do character sketches, and I decide, okay, this will be the career my character will be doing, or this will be his physical status or anything. And then I give outlines to every chapter. This is the theme, so my story will be divided into, say, 20 chapters. So I give outline to every chapter. Okay, in this chapter, I'll write about this. In this chapter, my character will be doing this. So that I don't get a writer's block in between. And then I just enlarge my chapters. Yeah, it happens that sometimes you have written 20 chapters, you have given outline, but it may happen that on 15 chapter you feel that no, the story can be changed a bit over here. So it's okay to change. I'm not rigid that no, I have to write this only. But now that I know that this is the outline I need to follow, I can change a bit. But I had a mantra that, okay, if I stop somewhere, I know that this is where I have to go. So this is the way my story proceeds.
Great, that's awesome. And how much time does it take for you to write these books?
I started writing my first book during the first year of my college. It took me 4 years to complete that because I was doing my graduation, my CA studies and my internship. But because I didn't publish that book, I was not very happy with that book and I just left it. But because of those 4 years experience, I was able to write both these books in 4 to 5 months each.
Oh, that's like a really short period of time.
No, because I was very clear that this is what I want to write. So it just happened.
So in those 4 to 5 months, how many hours did you devote to writing per day?
Yeah, like initially when I started, I was searching for the story, it was like I was writing any time of the day. Sitting in a cafe and I was just jotting points. And it may happen that sometimes I'll write 100 pages at a stretch. Sometimes I'm just able to write 2 pages. So there was no fixed time, but I used to sit with my diary and my pen every day for lots of hours. And it just happened.
The characters in your book, are they real life people around you or are they completely fictional?
They are a combination of reality and fiction world, both the worlds. Most of the characters, like almost all the characters, are inspired from people around me, my friends. Some are inspired from my own life, my own experiences or my own dreams. So they are a combination of both.
So I can actually draw an analogy. In your latest book, This Is Not Your Story, the character of Shaurya is somewhat similar to your...
Yeah, Shaurya's character is like very much inspired from my life. Even he is doing CA, but his parents are forcing him to do CA, that he wants to be a filmmaker. Shaurya's character is very much inspired from my own life.
And in your first book, there's a character, Meera, who is again writing a book in an author. So you know, both these characters probably are somewhere...
Yes, that's it. Like, I was searching for my first story and I was thinking what to write. And I just thought that whatever I'm going through right now, let's put this in form of a character. And from there, Meera's character came. She wants to be right there. She's searching for a story that can touch people's soul. And I just wrote about it.
So that is how probably you managed to touch everyone's soul through the book as well.
Because when you are honest to your story, when you are honest with whatever you are writing, you can touch people's heart. Because we are all humans and we are all connected. So whatever you write, they'll say, it will reach them.
You self-published your books, you know, that's like a really tough task. People look for agents to go and publish their books, and they run after publishing agencies. How did you manage to do that? What was the procedure then?
Once my story was about to complete, I was pretty sure that it's a good story because I written it very honestly. And I felt that this is a good story, people will like it. And if I would have waited for traditional publishers, it might have taken time because they might reply in 4 days, 4 months, 4 days, or 4 weeks, or maybe years. pen. They might just reject my manuscript. So I thought I'll self-publish it. And I decided to go directly to the printers. I asked them, this is the book, I want to get 1,000 copies printed. So just do it for me. Then I opened a seller center account on Amazon. I put my books over there. So I was the writer, the publisher, distributor, marketer, everything for my book. It was a bit tough because I was working round the clock and it's like a one-man army. So it takes time, but I think that because of my experience, I can say that self-publishing is not hard. Mm-hmm. There was a time when people used to say that self-publishing you can't get success. But I see that I'm an example that you can get success in self-publishing if you work smartly and if you work very hard.
So how do you market your books to your readers, like after putting it out on Amazon and any other online portals? What was the trigger point?
It was Facebook that helped me. Like my initial readers, when they read the book, they said that my book has some lines which are very, very inspiring and which really motivates them. So I just made images of those quotes, of those lines, and I just put them on Facebook. And it just went viral. People started keeping them as their WhatsApp status, Facebook status, and word of mouth were on their Facebook.
Yes, that's amazing. And tell us about your blog.
Yeah, Life and People is a blog. The name only suggests that it's about life, it's about people, because that's what we are here for. And I write on them about positivity, spirituality, traveling. So these are some of the topics which I'm interested in. And I just share my knowledge, I just share what I have learned in these topics.
So what is your take on spirituality?
See, people may say that religion and spirituality is same. Many people have that notion. But religion is something which is like, religion has a boundary. When someone forces religion on you, like, okay, this is your religion, you have to follow this, these are the rules. But spirituality is something which comes from within, it doesn't come from outside. So it is something knowing your own self and knowing the universe, trying to know the universe, trying to connect with the universe. So religion is like a drop in the ocean. And spirituality is like the ocean itself. That's what I feel. And I feel that once you are a spiritual person, you'll be able to connect with all the religions. Because all the religions at some point are same. They give the same message. They just have some boundaries. And spirituality has no boundary. Because it comes from within. And there's no boundary for the soul. That's what I feel.
So basically, spirituality is a combination of all religions and even beyond.
Yes.
And you've written about law of attraction. So can you tell us what do you think about it and how does it work?
I really believe in law of attraction. Let me give you an example. When I was doing my CA, I made a list of 100 visions. These are the visions I want to complete in my life. And there were many such wishes. I'll just give you some examples. To be invited as a guest at a radio station. To have my article in a leading newspaper. Or to be invited as a guest at many places, to inspire people and to do lots of stuff. And I knew that I can do this. Whatever I'm writing, I can do this. And if I believe in this, the universe will give this to me. And it just happened. I was not working for my dreams. Like, I was not working for the dream list. I was working for things which I really wanted to do. I wanted to write, I started writing. And everything just happened.
Your dreams all came through that process.
Yeah, and it was time like after an year when I was just going through my dream list, I realized that more than 30% of it is accomplished. So that's what law of attraction does. Many people, like there are many readers who message me that even we want to write. We even have a story. But the thing is, they are like, we are not sure if people will like it or not. What if readers criticize? So that's the point that is talking them. They don't believe in themselves. I knew that this is a story, I knew it's a good story. I will give it to people and they will like it. Yeah, definitely there are many people who will criticize your story, but there will be many who will love you, will love your story. So you need to believe in yourself. You can't believe in yourself. You can't ask others or you can't accept from others that they will believe you. So that's what law of attraction is. I'm a true believer of law of attraction. And I attracted lots of things in my life.
Wow, that's very inspirational. In both your books, Savi, you have, you know, really strong love stories. So what is your take on love? Like,
I think love is something which we all need in life. it happens that when people talk about love, it's just about a boy and a girl, husband, wife, and boyfriend, girlfriend. But love is eternal. Love to the universe, love our friends, our family. And love is something which we all need. It's love of anyone and everyone. And we are humans, we are there to give love, to share love. So I really believe in love, and love is very powerful. It can make you something too big. It can even break you if you don't take it wisely, if you don't understand it properly. But today people have given so many definitions to love, and because of those definitions, they've created a boundary. This is only love. But you know, love is something which can never be defined in words. You can just feel love.
Wow, that's a beautiful thing. Would you like to tell us a little about your latest book, This Is Not Your Story?
Sure.
Why have you named it This Is Not Your Story, maybe to begin with?
Okay, I think the beginning lines of the book give the crux of the story and about the character. So this goes like this. Remember, there is a cost for every story in your life. The cost for making your story better. The cost for not making your story better. And it's you who will have to pay for it. So decide carefully what you want and which story you want to tell. Sometimes what happens in life is that you tend to do things which your family, your friends, or you know, your relatives want you to do. And then you feel that this is correct, my friends are doing this, so this is what I really want to do. But when you sit alone somewhere and you feel that your soul is not happy, it's not content, and you realize that whatever you are doing is just for the sake of others and it's not making you happy. So this Agarwal says that whatever you are doing for others, that's not your story. That's not your call. You need to know like what your heart wants, what your soul wants. Just like I said, the Shaurya is doing singing just because for the sake of his parents. But he's not happy because he wants to be a filmmaker. So you need to find out what you really want to do. Many of my readers say that, ma'am, we are doing engineering because my father wants me to do engineering. But I want to go for MBA, I want to go for dance and anything. So that's the thing, you need to decide what you want to do. People say that we can't make our parents unhappy. It's our dream. They have done so much for us. So we need to make them happy. But you know what happens is your parents are most happy when you are happy.
Absolutely.
And it may happen that initially they are not happy. Mm-hmm. It's like my parents. They were not happy initially that I was living in CA. But today they say that we were wrong, that we were trying to stop you. Because you need to tell them parents are, you know, they are the generation which is far, which was far different in today's generation. There are many such things they don't know about. Like my grandfather, he used to read Premchand, and he said ki Premchand ji garibi mein mar gaye to book likh ke kitna kama rahe hai, to kaise teri zindagi kaatenge. But now time is changing. Authors are earning so much. So I'm supposed to explain him that no, time has changed. Premchand ji's generation was different, the time was different. Today authors are earning in crores in lakhs. So and once I explained them, this saw my success. They get to know that more. It arts can be a profession. And they accepted it. So that's something we need to do. We need to explain it. That when we were young, our parents used to explain everything when we were kids. So now we just need to sit with them, we need to talk with them, and we need to explain them that no, this is my dream. I can achieve it and I can make it out.
Parents sing right there. Okay. Okay, so coming to authors, yes, totally. So coming to your character you're talking about, you're talking about authors. So who is your favorite author?
I read lots of books, so my most favorite authors, I'll say Arvind Sharma, Robin Sharma, Devdutt Patnaik. So these are some of the authors I love to read. And I try to read many different authors because there may come a book which, you know, someone referred you and you are just reading and then you can think, okay, this is a wonderful book. And if you want to write, you have to read lots of books. And even if you don't want to write, you want to grow your souls. You need to, because reading is food for soul. So your body needs food. In the same way, your soul needs food. So you need to read lots of books.
I hope everyone will go get back and read a book at least after our conversation.
Mine first.
Yes, of course. So, tell us some of your favorite books.
Okay, my most favorite and the mantra I follow is The Alchemist. Like, the words, follow the words for them. If you want something, the universe conspires to make that happen, give it to you. So, I really believe in that. Then, I read Richard Long's book, that's Tuesdays with Mohan.
Yeah.
And five people in meeting him. They are wonderful books. I've read Sita and Jaya by Megha Patnaik. So they are about Ramayana and Mahabharata. But the way he explained it, like you can understand each and every point that, okay, when he says that you have a path, path is shrap. So it's about the deeds. If you have a good job, you will get a good job. Which is a good shrap. So you know, when you say that you have a path, then you will get a good job. You will feel that you have a good job. You will feel that. But to explain it in today's generation, today's world, it's like if you are doing good deeds, you get good results. If you are doing wrong, yeah, it's karma. So those stories were just to tell us that, okay, this is the circumstance, this is the result. They were all just stories giving us the mantra for life. The way Devdas has explained it, it's very beautiful.
So kind of bridge the gap between that era and today's
era. Today's era, right.
Would you like to read an excerpt from your latest book?
Sure, I would like to read the follow-up of my book. It's really object.
Yes.
For a moment, forget who you are. More importantly, leave behind who we are and empty out everything. Instead, just be me. I never wanted anything from life. If I say those words, I would be lying. In fact, that would be the biggest lie of my life. I wanted, I've always wanted. I just never could bring the words out. My voice failed, my heart breaking, and my soul shattered. But what do I really want in life? I don't know yet. So I will tell you everything I wanted and still want. Today, I will be true. True to you, and most importantly, true to myself. I want to live. Yes, not one, but many lives in one lifetime. I want to write about myself and everyone I ever met. Capture the essence of what it's like to live, to be able to read everything beautiful and painful ever written, and appreciate the experiences captured. All of this in hope to inspire and to be inspired. I want to learn and to teach. Yes, both. Because I've had life-defining encounters need to be shared and understood. Even so, I still have life-changing experiences and lessons to learn. I want to give away everything I have. Yes, I want that, and I want to begin again. To remind myself what it means to start over, to be back at the beginning of one's life. I want to eat and dress well, have a nice car and a nicer home, to be rich, famous and appreciated. The little things and the bigger things, I want all of them. I want to be single and yet attached, alone yet accompanied. I want to be everything and nothing, all at once. I want death to want me. He cannot take me. I want him to come. When I've exhausted these lives, I want to live and become. I want him to desire the enriched soul I will be. I want it all, slowly, gradually, and definitely. But is this all possible? Can one person be all these things in one lifetime? I don't know, but I certainly want.
And tell us about your first book. Like, I think, how many copies have you sold for this book?
I've sold around 2 lakh copies of my second book and 1 lakh copies of my first book. Sorry, 2 lakh copies of my first book and around 1 lakh of my second book.
And still counting, I'm sure.
Still counting.
So tell us about Everyone Has a Story.
This book is very close to being, it being my first published book. It's it will be always special. And initially when I started writing this book, the title was something else. It was writing a story. I realized that every character of my book has their own personal stories. Whenever they meet someone else, a new story starts. So there are four main characters in this book: Meera, Vivan, Nisha and Kabir. So Meera is an HR manager and she wants to be a writer just like me. And she's searching for a story which will touch millions of hearts. Then there's Vivan, who wants to travel the world. He's a bank manager. And you know, he is looking for a good time. When can I start? When can I start traveling? And when will I leave always and just go around the world and fulfill my dreams? And he's in that dilemma. Then there's Kabir, who is a cafe manager. He feels that he wants to have something of his own. He don't want to be a manager at someone's place forever. And to, interestingly, tell you, Kabir's character was inspired by one of the cafe managers in CCB. I used to visit. Yeah. So I was very regular in CCB. So I used to have a talk with him because I was a regular customer. And I just, when I was searching for the story, I just felt that I can write a character like him. And Kabir's character came in my mind. And irony is, he read my book after it was published. And after reading my book, he got inspired to leave his job as a manager and to start something of his own. Now he's in Dehradun, he has his own cafe over there.
Oh, wow. Yeah. So you kind of wrote his story before he actually did something.
Yeah, so like he inspired me for a character and my story inspired him to change his story. And then there's Nisha. So she's a girl who's faced so much in her life and she's trying to come over to give life a chance and to start again. It's a story of friendship, how they fall in love and how they help each other to fulfill their dreams. It's about dreams, hope, courage, and about love and life.
So you've told us about two characters. One was inspired by yourself, one was inspired by the cafe manager.
Yeah.
The other two characters, Vivan and Nisha, were they also inspired by your friends? Or?
Yeah, Vivan's business side was inspired by one of my friends and he wants to travel. That was inspired by my own self. Like, I want to travel the world. So that thing inspired me. Nisha's character was inspired by one of my friends, like, who was very deep grief when she was searching for something. And not just my friend, there were many other people like Nisha in my life. So I just decided to write.
Congratulations. Savi.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Nice hearing you speak. You know, I started reading at the age of 12. Started with Ernest Hemingway, Thomas Hardy, Daphne Warrior, and I've read up to the latest of Pankaj Dubey. What would your advice be to the youngsters? I see a number of youngsters over here today. Should they go for a course in creative writing, which a number of universities all over the world do offer, or writing should come from within?
See, writing the story comes from within. No one can give you a story and you can't just write. But if you feel that you want to get some experience, you want to learn the craft, it's like art and craft. Art is what comes from within. But the craft of writing can be learned if you feel that you want to learn. So there's nothing wrong in learning. So you can definitely join courses because it will help you. Knowledge is something which can never be reduced. Whatever you are getting in life, whatever you are gaining, knowledge will be increasing with them. So whatever you are doing, if you are doing a course, it will add something to your point. It may give you the craft which was missing. It happens with some people that they have a story, they want to write, but they are like, I'm not able to pour out my heart, I'm not able to put the words, I'm not able to give the words to my feelings. So maybe the courses can help you with it. So it's up to you, it's a personal decision if you want to, if you don't want to. You can't just say that it is good or it's bad. It depends on your own decision that you want to do it or you don't want to do it.
Hello, ma'am. So you said that you started writing before the age of 10, but you started reading very recently. Not very recently, but when you were in college. So could you tell us why?
See, I used to read. Even during that time, I used to read Premchand's stories and certain stories. I was not known to the world of novels at that time. It was not that I was not reading. I used to read short stories. It was during my college when I started reading novels. It was before that I didn't know about it. Maybe because of the friend circle I was in schools, and I just was not known to that world of novels and everything. But I used to read even at that time. And only because I used to read, I wanted to write.
Any more questions? Yes, we have one question.
Ma'am, I want to ask that every writer or an author has to be a good should be good at observing things, observing people. So in your case, is this instinctive?
See, observing just comes, just as I said that Kabir's character came from the cafe manager. Just because I was observing his things, his work, was able to get that character. And observing these terms, you just need to sit. Whatever you are seeing, we see. If you are sitting in a cafe, you are sitting in a mall, or you are just walking, you see the person next to you. But it's about how you take whatever they are doing. Their take on their actions is what you observe. Like the way a person talks to another person. You see that, you listen to that. But how you think about that person, that is this person good enough, like he is, how are his manners, how is he talking to another person, that's how you observe. So it just comes, you just need to think bit deeply, you just need to, understand certain things, whatever you're seeing or watching, you're listening, you need to understand what's happening. If you understand them, that's observing.
So, ladies and gentlemen, that brings us to the end of this very intriguing discussion. Thank you very much, Savi, for sharing
those
words of wisdom, and Nilisha for sharing it up with you. I also want to mention that today we have got two dear friends who are also lovers of literature and also, I think, doing a lot of work in a different state in Bihar. And have come all the way from Patna. We got Dr. Ajit Pradhan, and actually traveled only for this event. And this is Ajita Pradhan. So she is, in fact, I will ask her to please come up from Navras, Patna. And we have this a ritual of gifting a small little something to the author and to the Nilisha. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Oh, really?